Hi everyone, welcome back to Dr. J-Tech.
Double J gives you a whole new tech.
This is Jacqueline.
This is Jeffrey.
Remember last time we left off on how communication satellites are mainly used as a connections between two ground stations rather than direct communications with mobile phones. The question that we have for today is that if communication satellites replace terrestrial fiber optical networks.
Well, the most basic concept at the same frequency band with hertz. No matter what method wireless communication uses, the data transfer rate cannot be higher than that of wired communication. How to increase the data transfer rate at the same frequency band is an important topic of modern digital communications.
Basically, better modulations such as OFDM and multiplexing such as 1024 QAM technology are used. Since the transmission environment of wireless communication is the space we see, the same frequency can only be used once. Otherwise, it will be interfere with each other and there will be a lot of noises interference during transmission.
In contrast, optical fibers used in wired communication, the same frequency or wavelength can be reused in different optical fibers without interfering with each other, and the transmission process has much less noise. So better modulation and multiplexing technology can be used to improve the data transfer rate.
Well, at present, a single mode optical fiber transmissions for 10 kilometers can reach more than 10 gigabytes. And if it's not enough, you can connect the second and the third fibers, and so on.
If you don't want to connect the second optical fiber, you can switch to dense wavelength division multiplexing, so-called DWDM technology, using different colors with different wavelengths of light to transmit in the same optical fiber.
If one color can reach 10 gigabits per second, using 100 colors is 1,000 gigabits per second. However, base stations or satellites that are used wireless communications cannot do this because electromagnetic waves of the same frequency can only be used once in the same space. Otherwise, they'll interfere with each other.
The satellite of the Starlink project claims to be able to reach 20 gigabit per second. In the same location, this is the upper limit. But optical fiber can reach much more times.
That being said, as fast as you want, which means that the total data transfer rate of optical fiber networks is much higher than flat of communication satellites. So it is absolutely impossible for satellites to replace terrestrial optical fiber networks.
In some deep mountains or sparsely populated villages, the cost of making optical fibers is too high.
For example, if you want to build a 5G base station on top of Himalayan mountain, you have to connect an optical fiber up in the mountain. But there are obviously very few users, so what should I do?
The easiest way is to build a ground station on the backbone network and the top of Himalaya mountain and use a communication satellite to connect the two ends.
This is cheaper than connecting the fiber optical cable. Such application scenarios are rare in Taiwan, but are common in the United States and Australia. But how big a market can make and how much money it can make will have to be very careful study.
If there are few users on the top of Himalaya mountain, it is cheaper to use satellite. If there are many users on the top of Himalaya mountain, it is cheaper to connect with optical fiber. Think about it. Consider the cost of transmitting per each bit.
Well, let's talk about what made most of the self-media gone wrong.
Let's do that. I watched more than a dozen videos from the media talking about the Starlink project and the 6G on YouTube. The biggest mistake was that they didn't really understand the operating principle of base station. They forgot that the base station is not for one person, but for everyone.
The data transfer rate of a 5G millimeter wave ground base station can reach 20 gigabit per second. The satellites of the Starlink project claims to be able to reach to 20 gigabits per second. At first glance, the speed of the two is the same, but the actual applications, the speed of the ground base station will be much faster than that of satellites. And why is that?
Well, because the above data transfer rate of 20 gigabit per second refers to the total system capacity. That is, this base station or satellite is so fast at most. If only one person uses this base station, there will be 20 gigabit per second. But if 1,000 people use it at the same time, there will be only 20 megabit per second, since 20 gigabit per second divided by 1,000 people is 20 megabit per second.
How about it? Is it not as fast as you think? To be more precise, it is not accurate to calculate the total system capacity directly divided by the number of users. But in fact, it is not much worse. So let's estimate it like this first.
Yes, I also want to specify that to increase the internet speed, you must use a small base station, so-called small cell, instead of a satellite.
Yeah, I assume. A 5G millimeter wave ground base station has 20 gigabits per second for several hundred meters, but it needs to serve about 100 people at the same time. So each person can get about 200 megabit per second.
Well, we may assume a Starlink satellite has 20 gigabit per second for about 100 kilometers, and it needs to serve about 1,000 people at the same time. So each person can get about 20 megabit per second. Therefore, the base station on the ground and on the satellite cannot be compared directly because they are different concepts.
As can be seen from the example that we mentioned earlier, to increase the internet speed for everyone, the communication range of base stations should be smaller.
In addition, the diffraction of millimeter waves is not as good. So 5G and the future 6G are developing towards small base station, so-called small cell, instead of satellite, because the smaller the communication range of the base station, the fewer amount of people will use it, and the faster everyone gets it.
Well, don't compare ground-based stations with satellites directly. It should be emphasized here that 5G base stations are currently based on electromagnetic waves with a frequency below 6 gigahertz, so-called sub-6 gigahertz. The diffraction of sub-6 gigahertz is better than millimeter waves, which can bypass the obstacles. The number of base stations is about twice that of 4G.
However, due to the poor diffraction of millimeter waves, the number of base stations is about 10 times that of 4G. Whatever it can fully cover the ground in the future remains to be seen. Perhaps it is more feasible to build in a hotspot manner, similar to the current Wi-Fi hotspots.
Well, let's take a look at an example of a self-media video. The video says the Starlink project is expected to invest $10 billion to provide global internet services. Compared with China's $200 billion, the United States $150 billion is invested in constructions of 5G infrastructure, but it only covers two countries. The Starlink project is simply way too cheap.
Can you see where the mistake is?
Yeah, Starlink plans to invest approximately $10 billion and only plans to build 12,000 satellites, each of which provides 20 gigabits per second service worldwide. But China spent $200 billion to build 1 million base stations, each of which provides 20 gigabits per second service in China.
Can we calculate the total data transfer rate? How many people can it be served at the same time?
Assuming that there are 10 million people using 5G in China at the same time, each person will be allocated an average of 2 gigabits per second, since 20 gigabits per second multiplies 1 million base stations, then divided by 10 million people equals to 2 gigabits per second.
If the Starlink plan is used, it is assumed that China will be allocated 1,000 satellites. Then everyone can only be allocated 2 megabit per second only, since 20 gigabit per second multiplies 1,000 satellites then divided by 10 million people equals to 2 megabit per second. Compare the cost of two completely different systems and say that the Starlink project is simply too cheap. Does that make sense?
The reason why China's 5G infrastructure costs $200 billion, a large part of which is to meet the system requirements of 5G, such as fast speed, high reliability, and low latency� latency. So a large number of base stations and edge clouds must be built. These are simply impossible by satellites.
In addition, satellites require a lot of ground stations. Starlink plans to invest $10 billion for satellite only. The ground station should not be included. Therefore, the infrastructure cost is definitely not only $10 billion.
Besides, even if it's only $10 billion, it's just the infrastructure cost. It does not include subsequent maintenance and operating costs. And the replacement cost of the satellite is due every 3 to 5 years.
Think about the failed base station on the ground. Just send an earthman to climb to the roof to repair it. What should I do if the satellite failed in space?
That's when you have to spend astronauts to take space shuttle to the outer space for maintenance. But the cost is way too high. I guess they should just blow it up and relaunch. It's cheaper.
Wow, we talked so much about the communication satellite today. I hope all you enjoy it.
Yeah, I hope all of you tune in to our channel next week at the same time. This is Jacqueline.
And this is Jeffrey.
And we'll bring back more information to everyone. Bye.
Bye.